keep them going. Make wheels rolling, moving on. The white line is the lifeline to a nation. And men like Will and Sonny make it move. A good hot cup of coffee is waiting up ahead. And the rhythm of the highway hums along. Jamming gears has got to be a fever. Us men become addicted to the grind. It takes a special breed to be a truck driving man. And a steady hand to pull that load behind. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on.
Something very beautiful about a well-shaped animal.
Now, here's the rider you folks been waiting for. A young fellow that's cut a pretty wide swath through rodeo in this last season or two. A kid that we think's going to be very, very big star as soon as he learns to tie his own shoes. Dear folks, and one fine upcoming young rider, Manolo Higgins. Let's have a hand for this contender. Well, here it is, folks, and you ain't gonna be surprised at this. The winner of the Brema Bull event is Manolo Higgins, and that makes him the all-round cowboy for this year at the Lodestone Posse Rodeo. So let's hear it.
So you all drive careful going home, folks, because we need you back here next year. And remember, nobody loves a drunk cowboy.
Howdy. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Mr. Edwards.
You about done wasting your time on those mixed-up old horny toads out there?
Well, Tommy says I got a lot to learn.
You sure do. How to count money, how to trust people. You got a lot to learn, boy. A lot. See you tomorrow, boy.
Hey, ain't that a show?
Tommy's better than last year.
I'm sure glad you boys could stick around.
Hey, Tommy, I got a bill for you.
Just mail it on down at the ranch, would you, Sonny? I got a new accountant set up this year.
Usually we get paid in cash, Tommy.
Hey, Stud, I got your horse ready for you.
No, not this year.
Aw, come on, Sonny. I seen the way you ride that bucking diesel of yours.
No way.
Look, I got 20 bucks that says that horse can do it to you.
Yeah, here's 20 more.
No. That sure wasn't worth no 20 bucks.
You all right, Sonny?
You know, the only thing wrong with me is my head, and that was wrong before I got on that horse.
Well, 4 seconds. You beat last year's record by 3 seconds. You've improved a lot.
You lied to me, Tommy. You said that was a walking horse.
Well, he's walking now.
You know, you're just too old to ride him. That's why you turn him over to a kid like me.
That rocking chair? I can't?
Nope.
Where's your money, boy?
Let him be. He ain't no world champion cowboy no more. He'd be the world champion fool he gets up on that horse.
Hey, look, Grandma. Now, you tend to your knitting and I'll mind my own tail, all right? Well, you gonna put your money where your mouth is, Pard?
Get it up. Now, you didn't give that horse a sleeping pill or anything like that, did you?
Sonny, this horse is so mean, he bucked his hind legs off right out in the pasture. We had to sew him back on with a catch rope.
Hang in there.
Let her go.
What'd you break?
Nothing. Shut up.
Doctor.
You can't even stand up and walk, Tommy.
Just let them take a look at you down there, okay?
No, it ain't okay. We got a lot of work to do. Wrapping up the show and moving it on down the road to Bradley Springs tonight. No. Give me a minute with Sonny, will you? Appreciate it.
Sure.
Come, he didn't tell me you weren't supposed to ride anymore. Keno said you broke your back 3 years ago.
Keno is a nice old man, all right.
I never should have made that bet with you.
Forget it, pard. Well, will you hand me that box out of the front there?
This?
Yeah. It's a cash box. I reckon I'll be in there at the docks probably overnight. And I got some problems, looks like.
Looks like?
I need you and Will to haul this stuff down to Bradley Springs for me. That ain't far, but...
It pays for the first job. It's a matter of the foreman of yours.
Come on, Will. It's my fault he's laying here. He's just asking us to do him a favor.
Okay.
Will... None of these fellas is on the honor roll in the brains department. Now, they're good old boys, but I'd like to think that you fellas are looking after things.
Sure, Tom. No sweat.
We better go, boss.
Yeah. Remember, boy, this ain't Indianapolis. Take care of it, Sonny. I'll be grateful.
Betcha. I think he's pretty stove up.
Guess he wanted me to take that there cash box.
Well, thank you, Keno. Tommy said you were going to have a lot of work to do, so I'll just hang on to it.
Municipal Park, about a mile this side of town, just past the old fire station. You can't miss it.
How much time does that give us in the morning to come back here and pick up the cows?
Stock.
Oh.
Whatever.
Depends on how long it takes you to unload. Best be down by tonight. Leave you free.
That's it.
He's dead, ain't he? I knew it.
No, you old buzzard, he ain't. Let's cut it out.
Where is he? What happened?
He's gonna kick the bucket. Sure as shooting bugs. Ain't no way.
Shut up, Keno. Tommy's hurt some. They're gonna check him out. Hold him over a couple days.
What's wrong?
Something about his kidneys. They wouldn't tell me much.
His kidneys, huh? I told him he'll wear that belt.
Holding a cash box, right?
Now it sounds like we're holding a bag.
You said we're holding a bag.
Well, nobody, but it sounds cockamamie to me.
A guy got hurt. We're just going to hold it all together till he gets well, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Tommy tell you boys it's payday?
No, he didn't.
It is. Friday night. Payday. Fellas are thirsty and tired.
Well, I thought we had to deliver the load to Bradley Springs by nightfall.
Well, we're just not going to have the strength to do that, you know, without a little green nourishment.
Hey, listen, Keno, I don't know anything about your pay or your payday. All I know is we signed on to haul a truckload of goods here, period. Anything else is between you and Tommy.
Well, suppose us boys just took a walk and never came back. Don't get paid none. Now, you couldn't blame us for that, could you?
No, I couldn't blame you if I thought that was all you cared about Tommy.
I was caring and done caring. Tommy Trueblood was a jackass to get up on that horse. Me, I'm going to Dallas, and you know where you can go. How are we going to get this stuff together to put on a show tomorrow?
Well, Jephthah, somebody's going to have to work awful hard. Guess who?
Get that camp stove started. We get some coffee on, okay? Okay. Yeah, that ought to hold. Is that coffee ready?
Yeah, I think so.
You always do this? Sleeping on the ground? Eating out of bean cans?
No. As a matter of fact, we have a good season. We stay in big fancy motels, eat filet mignon all the time.
Oh, it still looks pretty rough to me.
Yeah, well, Tommy likes to say this is the way the old-time cowboys did it. You know, this is a chuck wagon like that.
Yeah,
except you don't have any old-time cows.
Yeah, well, it's just a show, really, you know. Just a show.
You always want to do this when you grew up? You look pretty good up there, you know.
Yeah, I like it. I want to be the champ like everybody else. Tommy says I ain't ready yet, though.
You listen to Tommy pretty good, don't you?
Yeah. He taught me some stuff. I think about moving on sometimes, though.
Well, like the man said, let's get this show on the road.
Okay. See you later.
Okay, tied off.
Yeah, figured she'd get here sooner or later.
Yeah, who is it?
Tommy's ex.
Oh, Helen? See, I haven't seen her in a long time.
You ain't missed
Lewis! Boy, am I ever glad to see you. Oh, you old son of a gun.
I don't know how a gorgeous creature like you ever found us out here in the sticks, but I'm sure glad you did.
I found you. Morning, Manolo. How's the boy wonder business?
Works good, pays lousy.
You get what you ask for.
Hey, you know, he's really pretty good.
Yeah. The hospital called me and they told me about Tommy's installment plan on his suicide pact.
Yeah. Have you seen him? How is he?
I spent the night there. This isn't some new kind of eyeshadow, you know. He's alive. If he was a normal human being, you know, he'd live, but he's only got one kidney.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh, sure, it has for some time now. And now the other one's kicking up or trying to defend itself. I don't know which. Anyway, he thinks he's fine and jackass.
You know, baby, I think you need some coffee.
Oh, you're not kidding. And some food and some sleep. What are all these guys sleeping for? Everybody up!
Here we are.
Thanks. I wonder when Kino's gonna get here. Where is he, at the motel?
No.
Is he laid up drinking somewhere? Huh? A day like this?
Not exactly.
What's going on?
He left.
For good.
For good? Why didn't you stop him?
Emancipation Proclamation, 1863.
Doesn't apply to rodeos. Oh, Kino left. I can't believe it. He's not coming back?
That's what the man said.
It's all the crew we got?
That's it.
We're 2 hours behind before we even start.
Hey, mind if I ask you something?
I don't mind if you ask. We haven't got time, honey.
There's always time, but that's not what I was talking about. Tell you the truth, I thought you and Tommy were divorced.
Well, of course we are, honey. We liked it so much, we got married again so we could do it twice.
What are you doing here?
I'm minding my own business. I own half the rodeo. The court gave it to me. And I want to make sure the show stays on the road. With Kino gone, I sure am glad that I came. He and Tommy were the only ones who could really organize this show. Well, got your working ready on?
Ready as I'll ever get.
Let's go.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Luther Pittman, Sheriff.
Lieutenant. Trucker.
Your boss around?
Been in the hospital since yesterday. Hurt himself on a horse.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. I always did like old Tommy. Well, then, just who do I see to run you folks out of town?
Why?
You ain't got a carnival permit.
Well, believe it or not, this is a rodeo.
Same thing.
How much?
$200 a day.
You know, if I had that, I'd pay it to get out of here. $200. You know, such an extraordinary financial imposition amounts to prior restraint of free speech and direct violation of the First Amendment of the Constitution of the United States.
I thought you said you was a truck driver.
I thought you said you were the sheriff. If you weren't the sheriff, I'd call the sheriff to have you arrested for extortion.
Howdy, Luther.
Well, Miss Truebride, this is an unexpected pleasure. I was just having a little chat with your attorney here.
Said we need a carnival permit for $200.
Check down.
Small dog, large bite.
Section 1045B states that any and all outdoor entertainment
events... Well, I'll tell you, Luther, what we really need here is some help. You got any?
Well, now, ma'am, I just happen to have the boys from the drunk tank here with me.
Well, that's wonderful, because we're really short-handed here today.
Well, I'm mighty pleased to help, ma'am.
How much?
Same, $25 piece plus meals, and mileage, of course.
That comes to...
Oh, call it $200, and I'll just go ahead and throw in the carnival permit.
Great. I'll get the money for you. You can unload the prisoners over there.
Yes, ma'am.
You got the cash box, don't you?
Safe as Fort Knox. I thought you locked it.
What you did?
You know the combination?
Yep. What'd you do with my money?
Oh, now, wait a minute. I haven't touched that box since Tommy gave it to her.
Must have been like this since we...
Where's my money?
Well, she's going to Dallas. Read this.
Oh, you can't get away with this, you lousy... Wait a minute.
You owe me for 8 weeks' work, and that comes to over $1,000, which you ain't got, but then neither is I. Now, I have took the $600... and $47 here. Leaving you some change to start the box office at Bradley Springs. Hope this finds you well and that you get better soon. I ain't gonna ride for you no more. Your friend Keno. P.S. Don't blame your friend Sonny for letting this happen. He just don't watch as close as I do when it comes to money.
Okay?
Okay. You know, it's very simple. Tommy gave the money to you. And you lost it. So you're responsible for it, see? And you gotta supply me with that money now, and I don't care how you do it.
I can't do that.
Why not? You screwed things up. Now you can unscrew them.
I hate to tell you, lady, but that's not how things work in the trucking.
Who asked you?
Nobody has to ask me for me to know when something foolish is going on.
Are you calling me foolish?
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did.
Well, whose side are you on?
You can both shut up. I'm sick of you weak, incompetent pseudo-machos. Get lost. I'm sick of this whole thing.
So am I. And the world will get along very well without this rodeo.
So can I.
I'm glad we agree on something. Let's get out of here before she changes her mind.
Right.
I'll tell you something about Mrs. Trueblood.
She's still following us.
She wants you to come back.
I know, but we're not going.
Okay.
Don't worry about a thing. Just let me handle her.
Right. Right, guy. You're the boss.
You remember Cheyenne?
Yeah, I remember Cheyenne.
That's when Tommy was still sort of a star. Remember? Had a little money then. That was before the first divorce. Do you ever know why?
Why what?
Why the divorce?
Usual reasons, I suppose.
Tommy thought I was crazy about you. Because we danced 51 dances in 2 nights. You ever know that?
I never did. 51, are you sure?
I'm sure. And he sat there. And he drank. Do you ever know that?
No.
And he was right. I was. Oh, hell! You know, the sheriff says we can pay him later, but you left the stock back in Lodestone Creek, Sonny. I can't put on a show nohow. Will you help me, Sonny?
Don't worry about a thing.
I don't think we could come up with anything like that.
Come on, I'll buy you a beer.
Oh, you do speak the language so beautifully.
Oh, that's all right. You two, you go ahead and enjoy yourself. I'll take care of the cow, the stock. Go on.
He's smarter than he looks.
It must be different than rodeo life. You really like the job?
It's not so bad. You know, I like the job at the inn. Next year, I'm going to be manager of the restaurant. I'm gonna let me come down here and look after things, so I can't complain.
Oh, that's good. Tell you what, the next time I come through Porterville, I'll eat there.
Shall I reserve you a table, sir?
Yeah.
Get you a room?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Quick, Edie.
A white depth charge. Boy, have I got a hangover.
Say, would you mind turning that back down?
Sorry, friend, can't do it.
Can't do what?
Can't turn it down. Gotta listen for my break.
Well, I don't have to listen to that junk.
Listen, that's me, see? I work for the station.
Would you like to join us?
What's his name?
Manolo Higgins. And believe me, he's going to be the next big star.
Yeah, I heard of him.
Oh, he's got a big following among the girls. They think he's really cute. Acne and all. No, I'm only joking. He'd be a good interview for you.
An interview, huh?
Listen, bring some of your friends. Huh? It's going to be a great show. A lot of color. A lot of your local people competing.
I get off in an hour. I'll bring the tape out there. Be more realistic. Yeah, I'll talk to your boy. See ya.
Everybody's got to start someplace, I guess.
Yeah, well, there's lots of places I'd sooner start than here, I'll tell you.
I don't blame you. Talent like you doing that kind of dog work? What happened to all your grub hands?
They walked out.
Well, I knew that, Willie. They come to me last night, asked me to hire them. I told them they wasn't worth the money. Tommy never paid them. You do any more thinking about that little talk of ours?
Yeah, I did, but I figure that Tommy's still laid up and they need me around here.
Let me tell you something. They're always gonna need you till you get too crippled up to do them any good anymore. Then they'll drop you like a dead skunk. What's Tommy been paying you?
Well, it depends. Depends on the gate.
Ends on the gate. Manola, there are boys out there in the big time that own their own airplanes. I can do a lot for you, boy, and I can do it starting right now. Manolo, this is Penny.
Hi.
Howdy.
I sure like the way you ride those bulls.
Thank you.
What do you say, boy?
Well, look, why don't I talk to you sometime this evening after the events?
Don't make it too late. This town ain't my idea of paradise.
How's business?
Pretty good. Oh, it's a little early yet. But the Boy Scouts in the Junior Chamber had a nice advance sale. Over $500. That'll get us off to a good start.
Sure does. Keep up the good work.
Oh, Mr. Pruitt?
Yeah?
I'm going to need some change here.
Silver? Sure.
No, all kinds.
I thought you said you just got $500.
But Mrs. Trueblood took that. I told her I'd need some change, but she said I'd be all right. I don't think I will, though.
What's she talking about?
It's mine. She'll get by.
That's not yours. It's Tommy's and the Boy Scouts. Part of it's mine.
No, it isn't. The first 500's always mine.
Well, now I'm the one that's confused. Hey, wait a minute. Now, what is going on here?
Now, what's mine is mine. Now, that 500 is mine, and you can't take that away from me. The court gave it to me.
Don't give me that courts and that mine is mine routine. You've got obligations here.
I don't have any obligations to anybody. Now, Tommy Trueblood owes me 500 a month, and he's going to owe me till the day he dies. And I ain't ever going to let him forget it, and don't you forget it either.
You are one selfish broad if that's what you've been doing to that man. No wonder this show wanders around half-starved from hick town to hick town.
That is his problem, not mine.
His problem.
Listen, if you don't like it, you know what you can do about it. And if you really want your money, you better pray for a miracle at the box office. Because after I collect this month's alimony, I'm standing right here to collect next month's.
Wait a minute now. Number 35 is in bulldogging, calf roping, but not horse or bull riding. I thought that was number 33.
No, you're thinking of Bill Jennings.
Well, then you do it. I don't know which goes where.
Oh, no, you don't. I did this last year, and you're wet crazy.
Mr. Pruitt, if we're going to catch that 1 o'clock calendar show, we better get with your boy.
Oh, yeah, just a minute. Has anybody seen Manolo?
Who could miss him? He was just talking over there with a man in a Cadillac.
I saw them drive away. Gee, Manolo took his suitcase and saddle and everything with him.
Mr. Pruitt, would you have a comment on that? Everybody's been coming here to see this young fella perform. Aren't they going to be pretty disappointed?
Well, we don't know where Manolo went. I'm sure that he'll be back for showtime.
Nope. I seen him leave with Elton Edwards. He ain't coming back.
He tell you that?
He didn't have to.
Why would he take off?
Who? Edwards is a big rodeo promoter, running a rodeo right this weekend over in Martinsville. You want an interview with Manolo, you'll have to go over there because he ain't coming back here.
But there's no reason for the people to be disappointed because we have with us today for a special appearance one of the great rodeo riders of all time.
Who's that, Mr. Pruitt?
Mighty Michael O'Herlihy. He's right here.
Michael O'Herlihy? Beg your pardon, sir, but where have you competed before?
Ireland.
Ireland?
That's right. I'm the Irish rodeo champion the last 4 years.
Is that a fact? I didn't know they had rodeos in Ireland.
Absolutely. Irish beef is famous all over the world. Indeed, Irish bulls were known there a long time before bull caught on in the New World. What's right?
Say, Penny, honey, why don't you mosey on over here and light my cigar?
Okay. I'm just an old cowpoke, lost with smoke, ever the time of my life.
What amendment do you figure we're breaking right now?
Who are you?
I'm just an old cowpoke, lost with smoke, ever the time of my life.
Bubble bath.
Cigar.
Wait till the boys back at the corral here about this.
Hey, Manolo, let me get your towel.
All right, let's go, kid.
Hey, come on.
Here, let me hold your cigar.
We want you to burn yourself.
Oh, you're getting out now.
What do you think you're doing, you guys? Oh. Is that crazy or something?
Slippery bronco buster. I'm not going in there. I'm on
Friday. You guys can't do this.
I'm getting the rug all wet.
Crazy or something?
No. And you just sit there like a nice little girl, and don't you make any phone calls.
And if Mr. Edwards finds out about...
Don't worry about Mr. Edwards. I'll take care of him.
You hold still. You're going to put a shirt on.
I'm not going to...
Hold it, son. All right. You want to go naked through the lobby? Come on. I'll make it
get sense here.
You guys are going to pay for this stunt.
I don't like it. This reminds me of changing diapers on my kid.
This reminds me of nothing I ever heard of.
All right, let's go.
The kidnapped.
Got it. Get the boots.
Got it.
I'll be back. Call Mr. Elton Edwards, please, in Mortonsville. The number is 65.
Come on.
No.
I'm sorry about the hair delay.
You're a fool, and you always were.
Grateful you could come down.
I look after my money.
Did you get it? I'd have sent you a money order.
I always get it.
Now, that's good. I mean for you to have it.
I know.
You didn't have no right. Who's gonna get married?
You got more to thank us for than you know, Manolo.
I don't know if you were born crazy or just got that way from falling on your head so much.
Well, I guess rodeoing ain't helped my coordination much. I sure could use some help with this thing.
I feel like I'm walking on your grave.
Hey, now. You ever know me to fall off a horse and not get back up? Well, I ain't gonna start now.
Sure, I ain't gonna do it. Yeah.
Forget it, I'm taking it.
Thought you were in the hospital.
Was.
What's that thing?
I got on a horse without this yesterday and fell apart, remember?
It's like a kid's doll put together with string.
You gonna ride today?
Sonny, you're the smartest man I know.
You don't have to. We brought your star back. He'll ride.
Nope, I don't need him.
See?
You need him. Where you're hurt, all that outside tape ain't gonna do you a bit of good, and you know it.
Come on, let's put the kid on a bull.
Look, you can't do that. If I ride today, Mr. Edwards is gonna lose that.
Come on,
if I ride today, I'm gonna...
Sure was good to see you.
Just sit there like a sack of potatoes if you want to.
Out there, that sensation of the rodeo ring that we thought was out of action because of a bubble bath. Bubble bath?
That's you, kid.
Move, clown.
Go get him.
Let me have it!
out there, folks, one fine upcoming young rider, Nolo Hicks. Let's have a hand for this contender.
Where are you headed?
If it's all the same to you, I'm getting married.
Well, I guess I'll go.
You heading home?
Yeah, there's a night plane to Portersville.
You gonna save me a table?
I doubt it.
Yeah, here's for next month. Save the postage.
You know, this is all very sweet, but you owe a lot of other folks some money, Tommy.
Well, I'm sorry. I ain't got it now.
You ain't got it? You two are out of your heads. Why don't you just stick together and save the postage? It'd be a lot cheaper.
If you stop riding, I might stop running. Fat chance of that, though. How much do you owe you, Sonny?
$300 for freight, $100 for labor.
Wait a minute. That's your money.
No.
Thank you, man.
Thanks, big buddy. Sorry I was so uptight. I get scared.
I know. Take care.
Here, you can't go out without a hat on.
Thanks. Can I go out without the horse?
Nope.
Why don't you just shut down this sideshow and go back to Nevada and see if you remember how to be a rancher instead of a play actor?
Well, that's crossed my mind.
You know, bankruptcy would be a lot cheaper.
I gotta get Helen her money. She owns part of this.
Helen just might settle for you instead of the money. You could give it a try.
Put this hand in the air. Folks, we right, now, when you want to go outside, you just haul her letter wrapped potato chip.
Ever seen. Here, now, to finish off our show today, it's
when
that,
I say that
great right. Irish cowboy, Mighty Mike O'Herlihy.
Let her rip potato chip.
Can't you find a starter button?
Come on, horse. Come on. Come on.
Sat on that horse, you might make a blockbuster.
Think so?
Except that I really think you're better throwing the bull.